Ah, I'm rolling over here. Hey, what's up, y'all? Shalom. All praises to Yahweh Shem Yahushai. That's the Most High. The Most High's name in Hebrew is not God. His name is Yahweh. And Jesus' real name is not Jesus. It's Yahweh Shai. That's why we say all praises to Yahweh Baha Shem Yahweh Shai. That we say all praises to the Most High. Baha Shem means in the name in Hebrew. So if you every time you pray to the Most High, you're supposed to pray to the Most High in the name of His Son. You just can't send up a prayer to the Most High. That's not how it works. So that's why we say all praises to Yahweh Baha Shem Yahweh Shai. Because He's the Yahweh Shai is the mediator between the Most High and man. Okay?
John 14:13. And whatsoever ye shall ask in my name, that will I do, that the Father may be glorified in the Son.
Oh, to the Father. That tells you, because the Catholic Church and everybody, they teach that Jesus is God. But we know that's not true. That's bullshit. And it's blatant bullshit and blatant lies. And you know what I'm saying? They purposely being deceitful and telling that lie. Because you read all through the scriptures, it says the same thing. What does it say? There's a Father and the Son. And they are separate. They're not. I mean, if you see the Son, you see the Father, but the Son is not the Father. Go ahead.
If you ask anything in my name.
If you ask anything in His name. So what is the Lord's name? Most of y'all don't know what the Lord's name is. Okay? People talk about, I love the Lord. Then what's His name? You love Him so much. Hey, because the Lord said, what did He say? He said, I revealed my secret unto the servant, the prophet. So that name was only given to a select few. It's not one. The Lord just don't give His name to everybody like that. Go ahead. Because that's that key. That's that skeleton key. It's going to open up all the doors. Go ahead.
You should ask anything in my name, I would do it.
If you ask anything in the name of Yahweh Shem Yahweh Shai, you know what I'm saying? But you got people like, well, I prayed for a wife and He didn't give it to me. Well, you praying for the wrong shit. The Lord told you what to pray for when He said pray. What, in Matthew 6 or is that 7?
Matthew 6.
Yeah, 6. And He said what? There's a few things you're supposed to pray for. First of all, you're supposed to pray that the Most High's kingdom comes. That's the number one thing you're supposed to be praying for, is that the kingdom of heaven comes on this earth and that America's destroyed.
My kingdom.
That's the first thing on your prayer list. Not a new car, a new house, a new job. The Most High is not trying to hear your little materialistic prayers. Okay, that's a quick way to get destroyed, actually.
The kingdom of God.
When you pray, you're supposed to pray that the kingdom comes. You're supposed to pray that the Lord forgives your brother of his sin and forgive you of your sin. Right, your debts, which is a sin. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, let's just get it. Because you know people, they all love to send up them little bullshit prayers. Asking the Lord for money.
Really? Really? Really?
Now I'm going to get that first king. A lot of people, they're materialistic as hell.
God bless y'all, man.
The children of Israel are materialistic. They don't care about anything spiritual. You know what I mean? All they want is that nice car, that nice job, that nice woman. They're not worried about getting that nice wisdom and knowledge. You know what I'm saying? They're not worried about that. They're not thinking about that.
But the wisest man on earth ever, what did he pray for?
I'm getting it. I got it. Okay. I'm getting that.
There's no knowledge and understanding. Here you go. This is Matthew 6. No.
They praying for that... That the greenest bag of kush. You know what I mean? That's what they pray. They probably really pray for that.
I know, man. You don't want to hear the foolish shit come out my nephew.
I already know.
But he said he's a righteous man.
Yeah.
After this manner, therefore pray ye, O Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
Oh, there it is.
His name.
That's the spirit. Hallowed be his name means holy. Kodash is his name. In Hebrew, Kodash means holy. The Lord's name is holy. Okay? Yahweh Baha Shem Yahweh Shai is holy. Okay, go ahead.
Thy kingdom come.
Yeah, that the Lord's kingdom comes, not Donald Trump's kingdom. Okay? And because, you know, Donald Trump is not a man of God like he claims. He's trying to half-ass quoting scriptures at his inauguration speech.
But so somebody was reading the closet for there, right?
Was they? But if Donald Trump was a man of the Lord, they asked him a question if gay marriage was, if he believed in gay marriage. He said, well, it's the law of the land, so we have to respect it. So he disqualified himself right there. He's out of there. Just that one thing, he's out of there. Go ahead. Go ahead.
Give us this day our daily bread.
Our daily bread. That's all we need is our daily bread. Just enough to make it from day to day. That's all we need. We don't need lavish riches, money. Because all your money is bullshit. All your material wealth is all bullshit. You can't take it with you. It's of no value. You know what I'm saying? With your moth-eaten garments. Yeah. Your money is worthless. You got it. Here there's some people, they barely make any money at all. Then they spend a whole paycheck on a pair of Jordans. Just get a nice pair. They go broke just to buy some shoes. Tell you how people are.
Give us this day our daily bread and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors.
Yeah, so it's all about forgiveness. You supposed to forgive your brother just as the Lord forgived us. Go ahead. Hey, that's another thing about our people. Crispy. That's the spirit you gotta be in.
It's coming quick. You ain't much older than me.
The Bible says he that loves his life shall lose it. And you know what I'm saying? He that hates his life shall gain everlasting life. So really, we're supposed to curse our life.
She told me, this was told me on her deathbed. She told me, I'm
blessing her. And you know, she's right, you know. We curse this life, we curse this world. our lives, you know what I'm saying? These little raggedy ass lives we're living out here. This shit's raggedy as hell out here, bro. We ain't trying to stay out here in this shit.
Man, we might as well finish this up and go into it.
Yeah. The people always trying to. Hey, bro, if the Most High jacks me up and kills my family members, you know what I'm gonna do? I'm just gonna pray to the Lord. I'm gonna keep it stepping, bro. He gonna fuck me up, take my arm off. He can take my children from me. He killed Job's children. And the Job stayed faithful and true, praise the Lord, and guess what? At the end of the day, he had even more children. More, you know what I'm saying? More money.
He had the finest daughters.
Yeah, the most beautiful daughters you could ask for.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So anytime the Lord jacks us up, we praise the Lord. Thank you, Lord.
That's right.
We love it. Bring it. Go ahead.
Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Yeah, temptation. What's that temptation? You're going to Satan will come and try to get you to break the Lord's commandments. Try to get you to do some wickedness. You know what I'm saying? That's something that's something you're supposed to be praying for, is that you can survive that temptation. You ain't supposed to be praying for a new pair of Jordans, for an Xbox money. You know, these people are simple as hell, man. Oh, Lord, please help me. I need money. You know what I mean? Fuck up money. What's that one scripture in that James? What is good of you? If he gains riches in the world, if he loses his soul,
what profit
is that? Yeah, that's a good one.
And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us from evil. That's what we're praying. The Lord delivers. Go ahead.
Check this out. My oldest son, me and my son, they got to pay a child for the other. This motherfucker found out through success, being a faggot, you get success, man. Now, this motherfucker, you can't even tell the difference between us. You know what I mean? You look at him, you know he a fag, man.
I want it.
And he's trying to get wrapped around. You know what I'm saying? Him and his buddies trying to open a studio and all this.
A studio.
Yeah.
Man, that shit done sell years ago.
Nigga, you seen me? You're just like a faggot, man. A peek everywhere, every day. A piece of shit.
That faggot shit's on his way out. Soon that time's gonna come, people just gonna start getting put to death, bro. Yep. The Lord is gonna start bringing that vengeance. And you can see it coming. All these riots, everybody mad about Donald Trump. You got the left versus the right, you know what I'm saying? All hell about to break loose. What are you looking for?
That's cool.
I'm going to get that Kings while you're looking for that one. Oh, hold on. I got some. What's that one where Solomon had a dream?
Therefore, set thine house in order, and reprove thy people, comfort such as them as be in trouble, and now I renounce corruption. Let go from thee mortal thoughts, and cast away the burdens of man's
soul. Oh, hold up. You're supposed to get away mortal thoughts. You're supposed to put on the immortal. The immortal's dealing with his knowledge and his truth. The mortal thoughts, you're supposed to get rid of all the mortal thoughts. Worry about looking good, smelling good, worry about getting money all day. Because the real money and real riches is his knowledge and his wisdom. That's the real riches. You know what I'm saying? And the Bible says, wisdom and knowledge shall be the stability of thy time. It didn't say a herpes-infected whore is going to be the stability of that time. It didn't say that. That's what you got out here, herpes-infected whore. That's what they're praying for. They you know,
it's true, too, man.
I'm just going.
They say most of the black women, 90%.
90.
Damn.
crazy. It's sad, bro. It's really sad. But you know, all them, you think about herpes, gonorrhea. I mean, that's rampant in the community. I'll throw that word out there, in the community. It's rampant in the neighborhoods, right? In these, in the Israelite neighborhoods. All these women got herpes, gonorrhea, they got warts. And that's a punishment from the Most High for being a whore. Because the Lord said, there shall be no whore to daughters of Israel. That's a punishment from the Lord. You can't escape the Lord's punishment.
That means you can't
pick
a bitch.
You can't. Yeah, that's wicked, bro.
They exalt Ice T like he the fucking hockey of God.
Everybody.
Yeah, that motherfucker was a piece of shit in the streets, but look at him. Big screen.
Oh, a big shot.
Big man.
Playing of what, a cop? Playing the 80 cops on here, now he plays a cop. Yeah, cop killer. He got a cop killer now. He plays a cop. Okay. That's a hypocrite right there. You know what I mean? He got stands, he has no principles. So we got principles and we got morals, okay? And we follow the laws of the Lord. Go ahead. What happened out here? All women, they fell into whoredom. And now all this whoredom is spreading like wildfire, and then the whole land is falling into wickedness. And then now you're not allowed to talk about it. Oh, you're not allowed to call whores out on being whores now. We just got to be quiet about it. You don't say nothing about it. No, but the Lord commanded us to say something about it. And we're going to say something about it. Go ahead. Yeah, you're not supposed to say nothing about that. You know what I mean? You're supposed to just let our people just fall into wickedness and just be wicked. You know what I mean? Yeah, don't judge. That whole judge not spirit, because y'all, that'd break that scripture down totally wrong. Because the scripture don't even really say that when you read it properly. It says judge not if you're guilty of the same thing is what it says.
There shall be no whore of the daughters of Israel.
Shall be no whores of the daughters of Israel. Go ahead.
Nor a sodomite of the sons of Israel.
Nor a sodomite of the sons of Israel. Keep going.
Thou shalt not bring the hire of a whore.
And the hire of a whore, go ahead.
Or the price of a dog.
The price of a dog. Now, what's a female dog? It's a bitch. Yeah. Right there in the Bible, the Lord called a whore's woman a bitch. Right there.
Into the house of the Lord thy power for anything. For even both these are abominations unto the Lord thy power.
That's an abomination. When you see our women out here acting like this, you're supposed to get mad, bro. When they out here being foul and filthy, unclean. Yeah, young and old, bro. There's no respect of persons with the Lord. Okay? The Lord ain't respecting persons.
Here you go, Proverbs 23 and 27. For a whore is a deep ditch, and a strange woman is a narrow pit.
Right, because you get with that wrong woman, you're going to fall into that ditch, and you can't go and escape.
Going in the ground and buried.
That's right. So tell you, you die of a heart attack and stress.
You got two choices, heaven or hell.
Oh, yeah. Or she go commit adultery on you, then her new lover comes. Shoot you or something.
Girl told me the other day, man, that the doctors told her to take this pill and you'll never catch AIDS.
Well, I
you
heard
can
about
tell a woman that.
I heard that pill.
One question.
I know? Heard the homosexuals are hailing it as a miracle drug.
That's madness.
See, I heard an expert saying it don't really work though. It just cloaks it. They just thinking that, I can take this special pill. You can't tell a faggot that, then he's going to become a super faggot. You know what I mean? You're not allowed to say the word faggot, don't worry. Because we're surrounded by faggots and they get offended by it. You know what I mean?
Sodomites.
The Bible said there shall be no whore of the daughters of Israel or no sodomites of the sons of Israel. A sodomite is a homosexual, and a homosexual is an abomination to the Lord according to the laws of the Holy Bible, which governs this earth, which is above all other law, all other laws. The Holy Bible trumps the Constitution. The Holy Bible trumps Trump. Okay? Yeah, Satan.
That's all he's speaking. They follow Satan anyway. Whether they directly know it or not. You know, they all follow Satan.
Like we always say, America's the kingdom where they created the Church of Satan. You can go join the Church of Satan in America, and it's legal. And they got a 501c3 tax exempt status just like the churches. They all part of the same system. The Church of Satan, Catholic Church, all that is all the same thing.
That's crazy. That's fucking crazy.
It's all connected.
This is Revelation 2 and 12. And to the angel of the church in Pergamos write, these things say, he which hath a sharp sword with two edges, I know thy works, and where thou dwellest, even where Satan's seat is.
Where Satan's seat, like Satan sits on his throne in America. That's where, you know what I'm saying? This is where his power is. It's right here in America. Go ahead.
Thou holdest fast my name, and hast not denied my faith.
Hey, remember when Satan tempted the Lord in the desert, he took him up to the high mountain or whatever, right? The high peak. Right. And he showed him the kingdom and said, all this will be yours.
Right.
If you just, what, if follow me or whatever.
Same shit the man Amalek does with these stupid ass niggas.
Yeah, they said, all this will be yours.
All this is yours. I'm just, you know, show me your soul.
Because really, through the Spirit, we know that Satan even showed him America. They're like, you can have this. And you know, the Lord, he's like, he don't want this shit. You know what I mean? Because this is Satan's kingdom. That's why we know this is Satan's kingdom. Because in America, if you read the Bible in public like us, the people look at you like you're crazy. That's because they got the vibration of Satan on them. That's because Satan got you.
Got him.
He got him.
He got us.
Got you. Well, you a devil. You was born. You was born a devil. So he ain't got to go looking for you.
But you can see Satan got his grip on most of these fools, bro.
And thou holdest fast my name, and hast not denied my faith.
So we ain't denied the Lord's faith, even though we in the midst of all this satanic activity. We ain't denied the Lord's faith. Yes, America. God bless America. That's some bullshit. Oh yeah, he a veteran, bro. You know, he probably got two of them. With a big ass knife, with a compass on it.
Dagger, a Rambo.
Oh yeah, Rambo knife.
Even in those days wherein Antipas was my faithful martyr, who was slain among you, where Satan dwells.
Yeah, well, Satan dwells up in here, but you can see Satan walking to and fro out this some bitch. Satan just walking up and down the street, up and down the street. Just walking to and fro,
oh,
fucking
Joe.
Shit up.
That's Joe.
But I thought Satan was cracked down in hell, though. How can Satan be in hell if he's walking to and fro on the earth? That's that myth, that another lie the church teaches, that you're going to go to hell and Satan is in hell. The Bible don't say Satan's in hell. It never said he got kicked out of heaven and went to hell. It said he's walking around on the earth. That's what it says. Man, that's some bullshit. And you can see Satan walking back and forth, bro. Yeah, he'll come up right up the shore. Because you see Satan got his little, he got his little minions too, the little sub-demons. You know, the little lower ghouls and shit. The little raggly-ass demons. What's up? Cause you got some raggly-ass demons, and then you got the more powerful demons. You got Satan, you got Asmodeus. You know what I'm saying? And they got names too. They do got names. Hey, that's why the Lord, when he went to cast the demon out, he said, what's your name? Then he asked him his name, he said, our name is Legion, but we are many. So you got Legion out there something. You got Legion chilling at the bus stop, bro. Right now, we over there looking at all these damn demons. Go ahead.
This is Job 2:2. And the Lord said unto Satan, from whence comest thou? And Satan answered the Lord and said, from going to and fro in the earth, and from walking up and down in it.
And you can see him walking all up and down in it. And he making deals with y'all. Satan come up, make you a little deal, and you take the deal. You know what I'm saying?
Take them goodies.
They like them goodies. You like your temporal goodies.
That's a good future.
With all the little bullshit riches you got or whatever, the little rewards you got in this kingdom, it ain't gonna last very long. You know what I'm saying? That house you got, guess what? It's getting foreclosed on. It's not your house. You don't own it. You don't own your car. All y'all paying payments, stop fronting. You know what I mean? It's gonna get repoed. You don't own shit, okay? People will walk around proud like they special when they just demons and satanic. You know what I'm saying? Blaspheming the Lord on a daily basis. Like everything's gonna be okay. Like you're gonna get away with it.
You're making money, but you're going to work, working for somebody else.
Right, making them money.
Good.
And they brag about it. That's why I get paid. Man, you get somebody else paid. Stop fronting, bro.
Get crumbs.
Yeah, you get crumbs.
It's about that same. You're going back and forth from the world. This is 1 Peter 5:8. Be sober. Vigilant, because your adversary, the devil, as a roaring lion, walking about, seeking whom he may devour.
Woo! Hey, what? Oh, that's a good one. Where is that? Read that one again.
2 Peter 5:8. Be sober, be vigilant.
We gotta be sober. You gotta be clear-minded. You know what I mean? You gotta keep your mind clear. You gotta pay attention. You gotta walk circumspectly. You gotta watch your surroundings, because you can't trust these people out here. We're surrounded by snakes. We surrounded by demons and devils and bastards. Okay, there's very few people you can trust out here. You gotta watch your back out this motherfucker, man. They will get you, bro. They'll catch you slipping. Go ahead.
Because your be sober, be vigilant, because your adversary, the devil, as a roaring lion, walketh about, seeking whom he may devour.
And really what that's really talking about is turning your heart away from the Lord. That's really what that's talking about. And they get you to turn your heart away from the Lord. How? Getting you to accept all these abominable practices like homosexuality. You know what I mean? Eating pork, that's a big deal, bro. You can't be putting that filth in your body. There are people celebrating Christmas. That's Satan that got you celebrating Christmas. That's not in the scriptures. The one they call Jesus did not celebrate Christmas, nor did he sanction it. Okay?
Luke 21:23. Take heed to yourselves. That anytime your heart be overcharged with suffering and darkness and drunkenness and cares of this life.
Cares of this life. People care about it. All they do is wake up every day, they toil, work, get money. And by the time you spend all them years getting money and working, now it's time to die and you out of there. Okay, you just wasted your whole life. You know what I'm saying? When you could have been searching after spiritual riches. You know what I'm saying? Spiritual jewels. Go ahead.
And so that day come upon you unawares, for as a snare shall it come on all of them that dwell on the face of the whole earth. Watch ye therefore and pray always, that ye may be accounted worthy to escape all these things.
Hey, that's what we do. We pray that the Lord count us worthy, so we can escape this shit. You know what I mean? Go ahead.
That shall come to pass and to stand before the Son of Man.
The Son of Man, who's Yahweh Shai. Okay? Because we all got to answer to Yahweh, Baha Hashem Yahweh Shai at the end of the day. Ain't none of us exempt from that one. You know what I'm saying? So at the end of the day, we all gotta go before the Lord. And when the Lord questions you, he gonna ask you, was you about my father's business? And you better have the right answer. You know what I'm saying? And the Lord said that himself. When he turned 12 years old, his parents couldn't find him. It's like, where'd he go? They looked, what, for like a week for him or something? Couldn't find for a week. He found him up in the temple. He's like, woman, don't you know? I forget how he said it. He's like, don't you know I got to be about my father's business? We got time to be playing games. We got work to do. You know what I mean?
Still treat like a child.
Right. But he tell you, he's in that business. That's why we mean business. This ain't a game to us. We mean business. And that's why we out here. That's why we serious.
Life and death, dude. You know, dude, you get killed.
Right. At the end of the day, like, the scriptures say, let every man work out his own salvation. Shit, we out here for ourselves, too. You know what I mean? We care about our people, you know what I mean? But we want to make it ourselves, too. Blood on your hand. And there's someone like that, Matthew 23, I think, maybe. How he said the scribes and Pharisees that had blood on their hands. Yeah. Yo, ye Jerusalem, the killer of the prophets. Something like that. You got something?
Yeah. This is 1 Corinthians 2 and 6. Howbeit we speak wisdom among them that are perfect, yet not the wisdom of this world.
Yeah, we don't speak the wisdom of this world. The wisdom of this world is what? Talking about how you gonna commit adultery, how you gonna hit a lick. The wisdom of this world is the only math these people know is a quarter, half ounce, ounce, pound, kilo. That's the wisdom our people got. They know mathematics, so they can sell drugs and buy pills. They don't know no scriptures. I bet you they know what every pill looks like. They can find a pill on the ground, like, ooh, I know what that is. Crack it down, sniff it. That's a popular thing now, people sniffing pills. Oh, y'all heard that too, because I know a lot of y'all be cracking them down sniffing. They be sniffing them with their ass too. That's a popular thing right now with pills. And who do you think the government is the one flooding the streets with all these drugs? Because all those pills come from the poppy plant, and the poppy plant is grown in Afghanistan, and the poppy fields in Afghanistan are protected by the United States Marine Corps. Go ahead.
Howbeit we speak wisdom among them that are perfect, yet not the wisdom of this world, nor of the wisdom of this world.
Yeah, because this world has no wisdom. Okay? So we dealing with the wisdom of the Heavenly Father, not the wisdom of Satan. Because America is the kingdom of Satan. He all got no wisdom. Only kind of wisdom they got in America is how to be a faggot, how to be a thief, how to be a liar and a snake. Because that's American culture. The American culture is to be a big piece of shit. That's the American dream, to be a big piece of shit. That's what America represents, is fucking shit and diarrhea and filth.
Let me go to 1 Corinthians 1:18. For the preaching of the cross is to them that perish foolishness.
Right, because we preach the cross, we preach the truth about how the Lord died for Israel, and they call it foolishness. You know what I mean? We got a fool calling us fools. Well, that's a paradox. That don't even make no sense.
Well, unto us which are saved, it is the power of the Most High. For it is written, I will destroy the wisdom of the wise, and will bring to nothing the understanding of the prudent.
All right, go ahead.
Where is the wise?
Where is the wise? Where are all the wise people? Where y'all wisdom at? We want to see what kind of wisdom y'all got. Oh, you ain't got none. Oh, that's right. Go ahead.
Where is the wise? Where is the scribe? Where is the disputers of this world?
Right, you supposed to dispute this world. There's a whole lot of shit to dispute too. So, but y'all just go, y'all love to complain when you were home talking about how bad shit, but you ain't gonna do nothing about it though. You just gonna sit there and take it, you know what I mean? We don't do that. We got here, we do as the Lord commanded. We dispute the world. We come out here and curse the world. You know what I'm saying? We bringing up charges on the world. We testifying against this world and how it's wicked and how it's evil. And we praying that the Lord destroys this world and that he brings his kingdom on this earth. And all the
testy.
Yeah, and only a man can testify. A woman can't testify, because the word testify comes from a Latin word testes, which is where you get the word testicles. In the ancient world, they just testified, they'd grab their stuff and they would testify. So a woman cannot testify, okay? We're not misogynist, we just breaking down simple facts and truths, okay? At the end of the day, men is running shit, not women, okay? And that's